The Bay of Bengal is the largest bay in the world, and a quarter of the world's population reside in the countries bordering the bay, making it one of the most densely populated coastlines on Earth. The Bay of Bengal region is situated between vital sea routes and has facilitated global maritime trade since time immemorial. Its regional organization, the BIMSTEC, or the Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation, celebrates its 20th anniversary as at 2017. The region lies between two economic blocks, the South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation, better known as SAARC, and of the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, better known as ASEAN. Therefore, BIMSTEC has an opportunity for pooling the complementary strengths from South Asia and that of Southeast Asia. However, the Bay of Bengal region is still one of the least integrated regions in the world. It is also one of the least globalized regions in the world. As it enters the third decade, BIMSTEC should strive to achieve its fullest potential. For this purpose, cooperation among its seven member states is a crucial and compulsory prerequisite. We believe that to be competitive in the Asian century, BIMSTEC should focus on the most essential elements: physical connectivity, institutional connectivity, trade facilitation, infrastructure, the free trade agreement, and economic integration. These measures will inevitably promote people-to-people contact within the region. I would like to focus on a few important areas within the realm of BIMSTEC. Connectivity. In order to reap the main economic growth needs of the region, trade connectivity through technology and infrastructure should be expanded. The region is one of the least connected in the world. While there are many efforts to integrate, these are yet to derive tangible results. Technology. Similarly, it is also an important element as physical connectivity is the strengthening of digital connectivity. Technological innovation and information communication technologies represent a key to foster economic development, improve levels of education and training, as well as address gender issues which are so prevalent in our region. Food and energy security. Due to its strategic location, the Bay of Bengal plays an important role in the transport of global energy supplies. We must enhance the intra-regional coordination to optimize the energy infrastructure investment, including grid interconnections. Energy security has a direct impact on food security. These are the most important issues that finally pave the way for growth in any country or region. Trade and investment facilitation. Today, the Indian Ocean region is recording fast growth in terms of economic and productivity. The Bay of Bengal region is very much a part of this nexus. We must collectively work towards reducing barriers to trade and working on further trade liberalization. The proposed BIMSTEC free trade agreement is a stepping stone for the region to realize economic integration. Reflecting the increasing appetite in the region for greater economic integration, BIMSTEC members have already entered into several bilateral and regional free trade agreements in the region, such as the ASEAN FTA, ASEAN India FTA, RCEP, the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. Hence, the proposed BIMSTEC FTA is important for greater economic integration in the BIMSTEC region as a single community. Blue economy and mountain economy. The economic benefits of the ocean and mountains are areas that we should focus to utilize as a community. This should be done in a systematic and coordinated manner. Public-private partnerships. The development and growth of the Bay of Bengal region cannot be led only by governments due to resource constraints. It is therefore essential for the governments to venture into other sources, private sector and outside players as well. However, this needs to be carefully structured, monitored, and of course, well planned. Security. Security is the next most important point in sustaining growth and stability in the region. There are both traditional and non-traditional security threats in the region, which has to be addressed through a strategic framework. At present, population growth, climate change, overexploitation of fisheries, degradation of critical habitats, pollution, and deteriorating water quality are some of the challenges facing the Bay of Bengal countries. The pace and breadth of these challenges require regional cooperation beyond political fault lines. The Bay of Bengal has to ensure unimpeded lawful maritime commerce in line with international laws and regulations. Around 25% of global traded goods, 70 to 80% of China's energy import, and 90% of South Korea's and Japan's energy imports flow through the Bay of Bengal. Sri Lanka has taken a clear stand in this regard to promote international principles and values like freedom of navigation and rules-based order in the region. It is not only in the short-term interest of gaining economic benefits, but also for the long-term interest of the region, its stability, security, and inclusive growth. Other issues. India, being the largest economy in BIMSTEC, can play a vital role in its success. India's External Affairs Minister, Sushma Swaraj, during the ministerial meeting held in Kathmandu, and whom I had the great honor in meeting in August 2017, observed that for India, BIMSTEC is a natural choice to fulfill their foreign policy priorities of neighborhood first and act east. India's renewed interest in BIMSTEC can impart a fresh dynamism into all areas of cooperation under BIMSTEC. BIMSTEC should also actively engage in outreach activities to gain from similar organizations and UN agencies to increase its capacity. On a subject or issue basis, for example, in the field of Indian Ocean maritime safety and security, it may create links with the Indian Ocean Rim Association, IORA, the International Maritime Organization, IMO, and other relevant institutions in this field for exchange of information, best practices, and complementing implementation of decisions through concerted action in achieving common goals. It is also of great significance since, as a region, and the regional organization representing our region, SAARC, has failed to, for obvious reasons, which we don't need to delve into, to achieve the objectives for which it was set up. I think BIMSTEC can, to a great degree, fill that void or take us where SAARC was somehow unable to take us. Sri Lanka is scheduled to assume chairmanship of BIMSTEC in 2016 after the fifth summit of BIMSTEC leaders in Nepal. We're looking forward to working with other members to make BIMSTEC more focused to fulfill its objectives.